Guten Tag, everybody, and welcome to CNC Kitchen. This episode will be about how you can cheaply reduce the noise of your 3D printer and how dampening feet can potentially rattle your Prusa i3 apart. Stay tuned! I currently own two 3D printers, my Mendel 90, which I bought more than 2 years ago, and my new Prusa i3 Mark II. Just a short side note. I have my new tungsten nozzle mounted since yesterday, which I got from supporting the DDD Material Kickstarter. Both of them operate in my bureau. I've printed many things already overnight with my Mendel 90, and even though my bedroom is right next to it, I never really was able to hear it. This was quite different with the Prusa i3. Even though I'm always running it in silence mode and use dryland bearings, I was able to hear it during the night, which really bothered me. I've then printed out the anti-vibration feet, which you can find on Thingiverse. These really solved the noise issue, but led to vibration problems, on which I'll go more in depth later. Then I finally found the proper solution. Jordan C. posted a neat fix on Prusa's forum. He suggested using a cheap paver from the hardware store and put it under the printer. I paid 2 euros for mine, plus an additional 2 euros for the felt pads, which go under the paver. Let's listen to the difference. I've placed a microphone with fixed gain 70 centimeters away from the printer and ran a simple test G-code. As you can clearly hear, the stock configuration is the most noisy and the printed feet are the most silent. The paver is somewhere in between. I've been using the stone since more than a week, and even though it doesn't reduce the noise as good as the feet do, I'm now not able anymore to hear it anywhere in the house. But why don't I recommend the feet? Well, let's get a little bit more nerdy. I wanted to try out how the vibration behavior changes when using the anti-vibration feet. Now just some basics. Every object has so-called resonance frequencies. These resonances can be excited if an external force acts on it in the right interval. Exciting almost any structure at its resonance frequency usually leads to fatal results. A nice example for that is the Tacoma Bridge, which was excited by normal wind and collapsed after a short amount of time. The frequency of those resonances is in simplified terms depending on the stiffness and the mass of the structure. A higher stiffness leads to higher resonance frequencies, a higher mass to lower ones. If you are more interested in this topic, there are tons of good YouTube videos around which talk about dynamics. I created a small Excel tool which lets me create different motion patterns as a G-code file, which I can then run on my printer. I ran a so-called frequency sweep on my Prusa. I moved the extruder at the same speed starting from small travel distances to big travel distances. The theoretical frequency range is from 200 Hz to 2 Hz, but will be a little bit smaller due to the acceleration delays. If you take a look at the results, you can clearly see two resonances during that sweep, which are quite severe, especially the one at the end. This is a frequency which the printer will probably reach several times during prints. You can be quite sure that this will impact the print quality and might lead to parts rattling loose over time. If I run the frequency sweep test without the feet on the paver, there is still one resonance left at a very high frequency. But this one will barely be excited during printing, why it's not so bad. Of course, you could lower the accelerations of your printer and use lower printing speeds, but this will increase the printing time. And who wants that? For this reason, I'd recommend using the paver under your printer for making it run more silent instead of the feet. As I have already said, I'm not able anymore to hear the printer anywhere in my house. Thanks for watching, everyone. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Dislike it if you think the video sucked, but let me know what I can improve. Please consider subscribing, it helps me a lot. Auf Wiedersehen and until next time.